My team and I are taking a look at the factors that contribute to the successful overwintering of Minnesota honeybees. Our team is approaching researching this issue by presenting a survey to Minnesota beekeepers to record factors about their hives and which ones affect the successful overwintering most profoundly.
I think what the team is doing is going to be useful in many ways. The data that they're gathering is so important to beekeepers that overwinter their bees in Minnesota. Most large-scale beekeepers are traveling with their bees, so their bees don't stay in Minnesota. But there's a vast amount of bees for hobby beekeepers or sideline beekeepers that have less than, say, 400 hives, that their hives remain here all year long. Those hives are facing the tremendous, you know, onslaught of the Minnesota winters, and because of that, we don't have a lot of data about what Minnesota adapted bees look like. And it's not just Minnesota adapted bees, it's Minnesota adapted beekeeping. Every area of the United States or the world has different beekeeping practices that are more successful than others. And what is it about Minnesota bees and Minnesota beekeeping that survives the winter is going to be an important part of the survey that's revealed.
As a team, we would decide what goes into the survey and how to order things by voting, and we worked very well together.
The main factors are going to be the breed of bee, mainly Russian versus Italian, how full the honey stores are before the winter, if they were fed honey during the winter, if they have mites, and if they died off during the winter, how they died off. We're also going to be looking at hive structure to see if that has any correlation to the success rates of Minnesota adapted honeybees overwintering.
When the team approached me, I was very interested, especially at first, that they're such a young group, and having any young group involved in an agricultural challenge like this is very exciting to see, because new life needs to be breathed into all agricultural fields, especially beekeeping.
Working with my mentor, Dustin, has been a really fun experience. His help really nurtured my interest in honeybees and was what got me involved in honeybees as an agricultural issue in the first place.
I've always been interested in biology and participating in the Science of Agriculture Challenge opens up new possibilities for me to do what I really love.
I've definitely benefited from being involved in this project by just getting involved in the community and a lot of really cool people, the kind of people that get excited about this sort of data. And I'm also hoping that Minnesota beekeepers are going to be able to benefit from the outcome of this survey. And the idea of just contributing that to them, contributing something to society that's going to really matter in the long run, that's just super cool.